Okay, so, the only real major side quest left that I have not done in the game, it's called Agatha's Song. And what I'd like to do is find Agatha's house, which I have no clue where it is. I actually was looking it up online before I started today. Hold on a second here. Alright, her house is west of the scrapyard, northeast of Moresti train yard. Wait a minute. Nowhere near here. It's over here somewhere. Temple of the Union is on my map. I don't know where the fuck that is. There it is. Temple of the Union. It should be down here. What the fuck? I'm right next to it. Are you kidding me? What are the chances I'm right next to the mission I want to do? I am. Look. Holy shit. That's nuts. That's incredible luck. Now, how I get over there, that's another thing entirely. Oh, I'm nowhere near there. What happened? It was showing the indicator of a mission or something. Where the fuck is the Temple of the Union? Agatha's house. Alright, I'm gonna go to Moresti train yard. There we go. There we go. Okay. This was one of the side missions that you also got an achievement for in the original Fallout 3. Not a expansion. This was actually considered one of the major side quest arcs in the original game. Doesn't look like there's any way to scale this, so I'm gonna have to go around.
It's go time!
What? What the fuck? Are you stupid?
Back.
You are. You want me to beg you? You're sure about this? Long as you're sure, honey. See you in hell. Wasn't pretty, was it? I like how one swing, every limb came off.
Looking for that special something? See the world.
Oh shit. It's bye.
Please, enjoy my selection of high quality problem solvers.
There you go, I have my Abraxo cleaner that I picked up by accident. Damn, I picked up a bunch of stuff I didn't mean to. Look at this. Ton of junk. Oops. He doesn't have any stim packs, nope.
Thanks.
I have like almost 5,000 bottle caps. It's pretty nuts. It's out of control. Let me make sure I'm going in the right direction here. Oh yeah, I'm on top of it. It's the welcoming bridge. Here we are. The little garden gnomes. Hello.
Oh my. I wasn't expecting any visitors. My, my, my. You certainly do look a little bit worn out from your travels.
Good old prune face.
Just look at my terrible manners. I'm Agatha. It's so nice to meet you. Now, what brings you all the way out here?
Let's say exploring.
Honestly, there's nothing much out here. Looking for sand? Rocks? We have plenty of that. You're welcome to look around this area, of course. Don't let me dissuade you. I'm just trying to save you some time. My husband built this place way out here for a reason. Rest his soul.
I'll say I'm sorry.
Well, that's kind of you to say. Yes, he's gone. After he built this place, we spent many happy years together. We decided to cut off contact with the outside world and just depend on each other for comfort and company.
Surely you haven't severed all contact.
Oh, goodness, no. I have a supply caravan that passes here maybe once a week. I trade with him for whatever I need, and I stock up enough till they return.
Hmm. Wow! What are you, a prostitute or something?
Besides shelter? Well, I offer something in the way of entertainment. I play songs on my homemade violin and people trade me goods. If not in person, I use my husband's old radio set. The men in the caravan say it keeps their morale up on lonely nights in the wasteland.
I guess a homemade violin is never quite in tune.
Oh, you are a clever one. Yes, that's exactly the problem that I have with it.
Hmm.
It doesn't quite play all of the notes correctly, and I have to constantly tinker with it.
Hmm. Your husband's radio can broadcast across the entire capital wasteland.
Yes, my husband was very proud of the setup.
Wow.
He tinkered with that thing for years to get it working. I've tried to use it to get whatever I need, but I've never gotten a reply.
Hmm. Anyway, I can help.
Yes, there is.
All right.
My training depends on my violin. Without it, I have nothing to play, no way to make music. If you can bring me a violin, a better one, I'd feel much more secure.
A better violin? It's hardly something that would have survived the war.
Yes. Very sad, isn't it? Sad to think that no more musical instruments will ever be made the old way ever again. Well, fortunately, I know where perhaps the last real violin in the world exists.
Huh.
If you give me your word that you will recover it, I will tell you more.
Whoa, look at this. I want to help you, but that type of search could cost me greatly. Talk is cheap, but getting stuff isn't, or lady killer. If only you had something to help keep me safe, my little honeybee.
Oh, my.
Ah!
I didn't know I still had the looks. Well, you just made my day, you sweet thing.
Oh, my God.
Let me give you something extra to help you on your way.
Wow.
I have a small amount of ammunition that my husband left behind. A box of odds and ends. I don't think I've opened it in years. If you do this for me, you're welcome to take whatever you need.
Martin, give me my word, I'll do my best to recover a violin for you.
Oh, I don't think I've been this happy in years. As promised, here's the key to the ammunition box. It's right under the radio table. Before you leave, I have some information that may help you. At least a place to begin. It all starts with my great-great-grandmother Hilda back in 2077, before the bombs fell.
Oh, God. This is going to be a long story. You have records back then?
Of a kind, yes. Hilda sent a good deal of letters to my great-grandmother Mary, who passed them on, and so forth. I suppose the correspondence could be considered a diary of sorts.
All right. I can't even imagine that
it
long
ago. It certainly is a long time. That precious instrument has been through a lot. Anyway, Hilda was quite a special woman. Classically trained and exceptionally talented at the violin. Her pride and joy was her Stradivarius violin. I can only imagine how exquisite this instrument must have been. When the war reared its head, she was invited by Vault-Tec into Vault 92. They claimed the vault would be dedicated to preserving musical talent.
Oh, God, it's got Bieber, it's got everyone in there. Bieber, Britney Spears, fucking Nicki Minaj. Oh, boy. All right, is it? Let's see. Let's keep going.
Vault-Tec was always promoting the vaults being used for the preservation of the arts and all that nonsense.
All that nonsense.
Had a chance to meet many of the other musical talents of the world, so she accepted their invitation. Then the bombs fell, the vault was sealed, and my family never heard from her again.
Can you be certain it's still in there and in decent shape?
A special pressurized case. Inside the case is the perfect temperature and humidity for the instrument.
Huh.
If the case is still functioning, the Stradivarius would be in perfect shape. Hilda Stradivarius was named the Soi Stradivarius. All of them had names. That's what I want you to get.
Do you know where it's located?
That's the catch. I have no idea where it is.
Oh, thanks.
I'd suggest making your way to Vault-Tec headquarters in the DC ruins. That would be a good place to begin. Good luck!
All right, enough. Agatha's song. Well, here you go. Jeez, you had a ton of shit in there. A ton of ammo. Now, lucky for me, see, if you know where Vault 92 is, or you just stumble upon it, you would have just went there. I think if you don't have the perk that I have, which shows all map locations, what you're supposed to do is go to Vault-Tec, and if you hack something, there's a map there. But as you can see, we know where Vault 92 is, thanks to the perk that I purchased. So there you go. We'll go to Greener Pastures and then just head north, I guess. See, Vault-Tec's over there somewhere. Fuck that shit. All right, to Greener Pastures.